Okay, so today we're just going to be talking about reaction wheels and magnetorquers. We do not have any magnetorquers in CAD, so it's mostly just what they do. And I guess I'll start actually first talking about magnetometers, which we also don't have modeled because they're mostly electrical, but they would go on the end caps, which is this part here. And the magnetometers measure Earth's magnetic field. So magnetometer measure. And so they measure the Earth's magnetic field, and then the magnetorquers, which would be located here in between the reaction wheels, would then counteract the magnetic field to help us move a little bit. And so those are being worked on currently by U of O team, the torque ducts. And so we don't have too much information. They're physics majors, so they're kind of working on getting it to work. So now these are the reaction wheels. So Patrick, do you want to talk?
Sure. So the reaction wheels are pretty much just little quadcopter motors with brass wheels attached to the end of them instead of propellers. And they work off of the basic principles of angular momentum. So we spin them in a direction using, since we have four of them aligned here, we'll spin them in the direction that we need them to, and then that'll help orient the satellite and kind of change its direction where we need it to. And we can spin it up or slow it down depending on which direction we need to orient the satellite.
Cool.
Yeah.
So do you want to talk a little bit about the CAD? So I mentioned this before, but the reaction wheels are the only one that, only assembly that isn't mounted to a card. So they're mounted to the frame.
Yeah, so in this assembly formation here, we have that there's two reaction wheels mounted to the sidewall of the actual frame there, so there's no card attachment of any kind. And that's just kind of keep it all in a rigid orientation with the satellite frame itself. These will be spinning rather fast and not have a whole lot of weight on them, but we want them to be as rigid as possible to kind of minimize any damage that could be taken. The big block that you see the reaction wheels on is all aluminum, and that attaches onto the sidewall plate there. And we did this so that we could kind of slide them in and slide them out without having to mount each individual reaction wheel and induce any kind of error. The orientation of this is important so we can try and have it as center to the satellite's frame as possible. This will help with the algorithm that runs the angular momentum so we can get the best correction possible. And pretty much all it is just the motor mounts onto the aluminum cage. And then inside of that, we have the brass wheels. And then in order to determine what direction and how fast the motors are turning, typically you would have an encoder. But in this case, we put a magnet on top of the brass wheel, that center of the wheel, and then the purple cards that's in front of the cages there have a little device that will measure the magnetic field of this magnet. It's a very specific magnet. And from there, we kind of have this little encoder built in. And so that's how we get our direction and our speed that our motors are turning.
Awesome. And do you want to talk a little bit about the cold welding issue?
With the bearings and everything? Yeah.
Yeah.
So one issue that space has that we don't typically have anywhere else, like on Earth, is with cold welding. That's because we don't have an oxidized layer on metals that you would typically get in an air environment like here on Earth. When you go up, if you have similar metals, you can get what's called a cold weld, which is where you have contact to contact between the actual atoms on the material itself, and they can fuse together and create a bond. So to mitigate that, in environments where you're touching, like for instance bearings, which are an already adverse environment since they're in constant use pretty much, what we do is we have hybrid bearings in this case, where it's a sandwich between metal, ceramic ball bearings, and then metal. And this kind of creates a boundary between it, so you don't have actual metal touching inside these rotating bearings.
Yeah. And that was a fun search to find them. And
at the size, yeah. Yeah. They're very small bearings.
Yeah, so Patrick also had to take apart the motors and put the bearings in himself. So, and then like we were talking about today, some of the fasteners were kind of interfering. So they had to be, Patrick went and manually shaved them down to fit in. So a little bit of customization going on, even more so than like these parts, which were also designed by Patrick. So. Yeah, any questions about reaction wheels and or magnetorquers? No. Okay. Yeah. So pretty short and sweet. Yeah. That's pretty much it. Any final comments, Patrick? Anything else you think is interesting?
Not too much comes to mind. You know, we're using the four based off of grad students' previous determined work and everything. But it's for this orientation of using four is also common in space. You only need three typically to run and orient your satellite. And so four is typically used like this, just to have one as a backup. So fun little fact.
Interesting. Yeah, so Josh did the initial work, I believe, and he also tested it in the drop tower, too, on campus. So
yes,
there's some videos of that somewhere online. But yeah, so that is it for reaction wheels and magnetorquers. Once again, the magnetorquers will go in here. The negative space part that's located here is just to help them. So... yeah. Fun stuff.
Cool.